Welcome back. In this video, you're going to hear me say the word passwords at least 100 times. They are quite important in VCF. I've alluded to why in the past, but if you lose certain accounts or they go out of sync, VCF just has no access. It'll keep hammering. Like for example, if the root password on vCenter goes down or it expires, VCF doesn't know about it and it will just keep hammering and then it will lock out the account. We want to avoid that and I'll show you how to get your head around all the password stuff, including all the different methods. So let's get started.
First one we've got is rotate or password rotation. This works well for compliance reasons. What that means is on a set schedule or even manually, you can randomly generate passwords and just click rotate and those passwords for those accounts will be updated. Next we've got updates. And what that is it's a single account at a time. It's a manual process and you can't have any failed workflows.
Remediate is by far my most favorite password management tool. It allows you to get yourself out of some very sticky situations when you've lost passwords or when you have to manually update them. I'll show you exactly how to use it later on in this video.
Next, we've got password lookup tool. Handy tool to use in SDDC Manager. You use it via CLI. You type in a command and then you punch in which account you want to see and it lists the passwords that it expects to see in SDDC Manager. If they're actually different to what's on the appliance, that needs to be either remediated or however you choose to fix that. Okay, let's get right into it.
Log in to SDDC Manager using PuTTY. You will need to log in as the VCF account, not the root account. Otherwise, you won't be allowed access in. Once you're logged in, we need to SU to root to be able to use the tool. Type in lookup underscore passwords, after which you will receive a prompt as to which one you want to get the password for. In this case, we're doing ESXi. Hit enter a couple of times. The username here is the SSO admin account, so administrator at vsphere.local and the relevant password for it. Hit enter and it will resolve all the passwords for ESXi hosts. Now that you've seen what the password is on the ESXi host through the CLI tool, let's try rotating it to see what happens. To do so, log into SDDC Manager, Security, and then Password Management. I'm going to make sure ESXi is selected. You check the box and click three dots, or even use this and click on Rotate Now, and that'll start the workflow. If you open up the tasks, can see that should start going. It's in pending at the moment. While that's going, we should also talk about the rotation schedule. You can't do a schedule rotation for ESXi entities, but let's say for NSX edge nodes, if you came into here, you could schedule a 30, 60, 90, or even disable the schedule altogether. Let's check on that task now. Right, so we can see credentials for the root account has been rotated. Let's log back onto that PuTTY session and see what the password is set to now. Just need to make sure I SU back into root. Then we run the lookup passwords command again. The account that we rotated, or the root account that we rotated the password for on host one, has now randomly generated password. That's rotation working for you. Next, we'll move on to updates. Pick the root account that you want to update and select update. And here you just enter a random password that you want to update it to. So I'm just going to invert the characters a little bit on that password just to show you the difference. Shouldn't take too long. So that task actually failed. Remember when I said you can't update a password if you've got a failed workflow? Have a look at this. This operation is not allowed because it's still working on something essentially. And we've got a failed workflow. Now I have tried rerunning it and it did fail twice. So it was about time we looked into it a bit deeper and I'll show you how to do that now. To do so, we need to go back to the PuTTY session and we need to open the Operations Manager log file, which as you can see is the path there, var log VMware VCF Operations Manager. Then I'll just less the Operations Manager log. Then Shift G to go down to the bottom. Then I'll page up a couple of times just to find the error. There we go. So a general system error has occurred, weak password based on the old one. So I tried to make it too similar to the previous password. Let me retry that with a different password. I won't show that this time and it should succeed. There you have it. That password has updated successfully this time around. I'll bring up the PuTTY session and we can validate that in the CLI tool as well. So the first host has still got the random password and the second host has got the password that I just set. Perfect. So we've now shown rotation as well as updates. Next, we'll move on to remediate. To properly fake this, I'm going to log into a host directly and change the password outside of SDDC Manager knowing what it is. This will make it or force it to lose sync with what SDDC Manager is, and in that case, SDDC Manager will not be able to control anything by the root account. All right, after a couple of failed attempts, that password has now been updated. I'll jump back into the CLI tool to show you that it still thinks or believes it's what it was previously and how it now creates a sync issue between SDDC manager and the host. Now even a simple password rotation should fail on this host. So let's do that quickly. Okay, quick and easy test. It failed almost immediately because it has no control. And that's a quick and easy test to show you why the sync matters between SDDC manager and all the appliances. Let's use the remediate option now to fix or resolve this problem. To do so, go back into the root account, click the dots, hit remediate, enter a password that meets the complexity requirements, and you should pretty quickly see the task succeed, and we can verify that the password is updated. You can see here, the password is updated to what we changed it to. Perfect, so remediate works, especially if you're in a sticky situation where you're locked out of an account.
Damn, whoever knew that I could talk so much about passwords. Hopefully you've got a grasp on everything that we were talking about. Do go back and rewind and make sure you do understand this stuff as you need it, because it does become quite important. Now, we will move on to some more fun things in the next coming videos, but if you did miss some of it, the architecture for VCF is up in this video and deploying edge clusters in this one, because they are fundamental to VCF. Catch you in the next video.